Today, we're going to demonstrate making a change to a COBOL application using Visual Studio Code and Git, along with Broadcom's Code4z extension pack. The editor has complete syntax highlighting for the COBOL language. You can also easily navigate around the program using the outline view at the top of the editor. Hovering over the variables lets you see their definition in a pop-up window. If you want to see more, you can peek the definition, and it'll open in a larger window that you can even scroll for additional content. Likewise, if you want to see how the variable's being used, you can peek its references. This pops up a window, and you can click on different lines to see wherever the variable appears in the code. If you want a visual overview of the logic in the code, you can generate a COBOL control flow view. We'll pull the view over here so you get a better picture. Now, you can see how the code is broken down. Clicking on nodes jumps to the section of the code, even if that code is in a copybook. When you start making changes, IntelliSense will make code suggestions as you type, as one would expect in any modern code editor. Okay, let's go ahead and make an actual change. Since we are using Git, we're going to want to isolate our change on a branch. So we'll go ahead and create a new branch. We'll call it Code4z. As you can see, we are now on a local branch called Code4z. We're going to go ahead and find a spot to change. In our case, let's update a message. Here's one, account updated successfully. We'll add Hello World. Our update now appears on our source control view and our list of changed files. If we click on it, we compare and see the difference. Before we push our change, we're going to want to build and test it. So, let's use Broadcom's Team Build to go ahead and invoke a build. Team Build works by mirroring the changes in my local working directory to a corresponding location on the mainframe where they can be compiled using IBM's COBOL compiler. As you can see, only the things that I've updated are recompiled. Now that I've built the change, I'm going to go ahead and deploy those changes into a running CICS region that I have using Zoe Explorer, which is also a part of the Code4z extension pack. Here, we can see some JCL that I have in a JCL library. This JCL deploys my changes from my location on the mainframe into my test CICS region. I submit the job, I click on the node so that I can track the progress of the job, and after a quick refresh, I can see that it's completed successfully. If I want to debug the program, I can do that as well, using the debugger for mainframe extension. I'm going to fetch the source so that I can set a breakpoint. I'm going to go down to the area that I changed. There it is. And in the line before, I'm going to go ahead and set a breakpoint so that when the code runs past this line, it stops in the debugger. Now I'm going to go ahead and attach the debugger to the running server on the mainframe. And once I've attached that, I'm going to go back to Zoe Explorer and run a job that will submit this transaction. So, I'll submit the job. And again, I want to track the job's progress, so I'll click the node. As soon as the breakpoint is reached, it should open immediately in the debug view. There we go. Now we can step through the code line by line and see how it behaves. You'll notice I've set com-message as a watch variable. After we go through the next line, we should see the value in com-message update. And there we go. If we want to change that value to see what would happen, I can go to the locals area and I can navigate the data structures. And I could find the com-message variable and set a new value. Just for fun, let's go ahead and set Hello World to Hello Code4z. We'll make our change. Hit enter, and the variable's updated. Now we can continue stepping through the code, or if we want, we can press the play button and let it run to completion. I'm going to go ahead and press the play button, and in fact, we can stop debugging now and let's go and see the output. I'm going to go back to Zoe Explorer and refresh my job, And here I expect to see hello Code4z in the job output. So let's go and see what we got. As expected, we got hello Code4z. All right, at this point, we may want to go ahead and push our change to the central repo. We'll go ahead and put a commit message. Hello Code4z seems as good as any. We'll go ahead and commit the code. And we'll go ahead and publish the branch up to the central repo. Remember, up until now, I've been working on a local branch. I'm now prompted to create a pull request for the branch I sent to the central repo. A pull request provides a method to allow for code reviews and other processes, such as source code scanning, to happen before code is committed to the main branch. I'm going to go ahead and create one. You can see I can assign my pull request to someone else or have somebody do a code review. I can look at various changes, I can add comments. In my case, though, I'm just going to go ahead and merge this onto the trunk. The code is now merged, which is going to trigger a CI process in Jenkins. Over here, we can see it's already running. Once the CI process is finished and everything's been deployed to the mainframe, you can go and you can see what changes have been made. Over there is my hello Code4z change. I can even see what job was used to deploy everything. But ultimately, at this point, my change is out of my hands and ready for the next level of test. In summary, you've seen me access the source code, branch it, edit it, build it, debug it, and merge it using the Code4z extension pack, which is available at no charge in the Visual Studio Code Marketplace.